Very good morning to all the children. Yes, Peter, we are going to start new chapter of Vistas only. Fine. So kindly bring this book. I would be sharing screen with you all, but before that, a detailed introduction of the chapter. Fine. I'll be introducing you all the characters first, and then the theme, and then we will start the chapter. Fine. So tomorrow onwards, be ready with your Vistas only. Flamingo ke jitne chapters karne the, we have done now. Two chapters are left. One is the enemy and the other one is the third level. So complicated chapters and try to be very, very fine, attentive. So the characters, sit straight, Anshul. Dr. Sadao, fine. Dr. Sadao is the protagonist, main character. And you should remember that he is a Japanese doctor. Fine. He's a Japanese doctor and he completed his higher studies from America. Clear? And the background of the chapter is World War II. World War is prevailing and such kind of circumstances at the back of the chapter. Fine. The background is set amidst this war-like circumstances. So multiple themes are there. I have written just four today. Apart from this also, we have themes and more characters are also there. But these are the major characters. Minor characters I'll be introducing you tomorrow when we will be having books. Okay. So Dr. Sadao, he's a Japanese doctor. He is the protagonist and he completed his higher studies from America. Fine. And after that, he became a doctor and now he will be serving to his own country. So what happened? When World War was prevailing, everybody was called to attend the duties. You know, doctors do have duties to serve the injured people in the army. So they do have duties. They were appointed. But Dr. Sadao, he was not sent at the border to attend the injured people during the World War. Why? The reason was that, number one, Dr. Sadao was one of the proficient doctors of Japan. Fine. Secondly, he was supposed to attend the general of Japanese army. This is a designation. This is not the name. Okay. Jaise hote na, the general of the army, soldiers are there, different designations are there. So the general who is the main part of that Japanese army, he was not well. His health was deteriorating. So to keep a check and keep an eye on the health of this general, Dr. Sadao was there in Japan only. Fine. He was not deputed on any particular duty. Clear? So why he didn't join other people? Because he was supposed to attend the general. Now, what happens when he goes to America for higher studies? He started liking a girl, fine? And he had liking for that girl and she was also a doctor, a batchmate. Both of them got married and they just built a beautiful house at the Japanese coast, coastal area. Coastal area, you understand, at the seashore. So at the seashore, they built a beautiful house. They started living. But his father was not having, you know, that kind of, you can say, yes in that marriage. But even after struggling, then he finally, he got married to the girl of his choice. So then what happens? So name of the girl is Hana. Both are husband and wife. Now both are doctors. Clear? Now, third character is Tom. He is American prisoner of war in Japan. You know, when war-like circumstances are there, it happens that many people are captured from an opposite country. So Tom was one of the prisoners who was caught by Japanese army and he ran away from there. Fine, that's why I have written American prisoner. So he ran from the prison. And he, you know, after facing many difficulties, he was lying on the coastal area at the same place where Hana and Dr. Sadao live. Clear? So situation is that that Dr. Sadao is now having conflict between duty towards nation and profession. He is having a patient in front of him, fine, a victim of war. Now the duty between, why he is torn? Because if he will be helping that man, he is not obeying the law of his country. He is not supposed to help the person of opposite country. Clear? Secondly, he, as a profession, as a doctor, our first and foremost duty is to serve the needy, the person who is in need at that time, trying to attend that patient immediately. So when he and his wife, when they were standing at the coastal area, they found one dead body kind of person lying, and they were not aware whether it is dead or alive. They thought that one of the fishermen, because many of the fishermen, you know, they used to dive into the sea, they, due to the bad weather, many of them used to die also. So they thought one of the fishermen of the countries is there. So they just checked, and when they just turned the body upside down and they found that uniform, the cap, initials of American army, everything just depicted that he was the prisoner of the war. So now if they will help that prisoner, and if their country gets to know, or the people or higher authorities, their life will be in trouble, that you are helping the enemy. That's why the name of the chapter is The Enemy. Who is the enemy here? Next character is Tom, American prisoner. About whom I'm talking about, who was lying at the coastal area. Clear? I'll be asking any of you, then I'll continue. Fine, Dr. Hana and Sadao, husband and wife. Then Tom is the American prisoner. That's why the name of the chapter is The Enemy, whether to help the enemy or not. And then the general of Japanese army, whose health is deteriorating, and Dr. Sadao will be helping him. So now he's also scared that if general gets to know, the chief general of the army, if he gets to know that I have given shelter to that enemy, so when he finds that a body, I cannot say directly a body or a person, Tom over there, he thought of, you know, throwing him back into the water. Firstly, he thought I should throw back in water. Then after that, he realizes, no, as a doctor, it is my duty to attend him. So both husband and wife, they decided to attend him. They took him into their house and they start treating him. Fine. And it takes so many days. And when that enemy was in consciousness, fine, when he was in his awareness that, yes, I am having stay at a Japanese person's home, then he realizes that what should I do? I should run away from this place. Fine. So he thought of, first thought came into his mind to sneak away. He thought, why this Japanese doctor is helping me? There can be some, you know, bad intentions. He will be sending me back to jail. But when he realizes, doctor also had same thoughts. After treating him, he thought, now I have treated him, I have completed my duty as a doctor. What should I do now? Whether I should kill him, whether I should ask the authorities to catch him, or I should ask him to leave the place. Yes, boys? So that was the conflict, and what happens at the end, that we will read in the chapter only. Clear? So now coming back to theme, conflict, this theme is clear to you. One should rise above prejudice. Prejudice, what do you mean by prejudice? Anyone sitting here, Dipin, Samya, Kanshul, any one of you know? What do you mean by prejudice? Sitting at home, bachche, jaldi se raise your hand and tell me. What do you mean by prejudice? One should rise above the prejudice. What does it mean? Nobody knows the meaning of it. Kakshi, can you tell us? Yes, those who are listening to me, kindly send me thumbs up so that I can see you are listening. Srishti is there, Sukhmanjot, Rana Gurjeet, Anushka. Rest of the students are absent then. अपूर्व, काक्षी, जगराज, दिव्यलीन. इट मीन्स दे आर नॉट लिसनिंग. दिव्यलीन डिड नॉट रिस्पॉन्ड एंड काक्षी डिड नॉट रिस्पॉन्ड. सो टू ऑफ देम टूडे. के सुखमन ज्योतिष, नोटिंग डाउन द नेम्स नाउ. सो यस सुखमन ज्योति, डू यू नो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ प्रेजुडिस? No response. It means you people. Yes, Sukman Jot, you can speak.
Not exact meaning.
Okay, fine. So she doesn't know the exact meaning. Let me tell you, when we have preconceived notions about someone, and on the basis of those preconceived notions, we start differentiating, fine, with the person that he is. Hailing from this community, I should behave like this with this person. He's a Pakistani, I should not talk to him. Fine, if Pakistan person says, okay, this person is coming from India, we should treat him badly. Fine, having prejudice about preconceived notions about others and treating them on the grounds of that is called this Bhedbhav. Clear? So one should rise above the prejudice. Then third theme, beta. That is the logo of your school, Service to Humanity. You know that what is the logo of Swami Sandas Public School? That is Service to Humanity. So this is the theme of this chapter also, that one should be ready to serve the humanity. You people never know that. You just know that we are coming to school and you know that one Gurdwara is associated with our school and they keep on serving the humanity without even telling anyone. Many people are getting free medical aid. Fine, many people are getting free education and other things also. So that is a true service to humanity. How this point is associated in this service to humanity? A doctor should serve humanity. He should be humanitarian first. He should think about his nationality later on. Clear? So next is love and compassion make you better human being. Being human, the logo of Salman Khan, you will always remember. Fine, being human. So he says, one should be have compassion for others, have love and care for others. And at least we should treat others like human beings, not treat them like animals, right? So if we will have compassion for others, it will make you better human beings. So these are the themes, clear? And characters, clear to everyone? Let me share the screen for you now. I would be reading, the children sitting here better, kindly pay attention, okay? This chapter is written by Pearl S. Burke. So, background of the war, they have mentioned in the beginning. It is the time of the World War. An American prisoner of war is washed ashore in a dying state and is found at the doorstep of a Japanese doctor. Fine? Should he save him as a doctor or hand him over to the army as a patriot? So this is the problem, that whether he should hand him over as a patriot or he should treat him as a doctor, that is the dilemma. D-I-L-E-M-M-A. Dilemma is a state of confusion. Yes, the full name of doctor is Dr. Sadao Hoki, H-O-K-I. Dr. Sadao Hoki's house was built on a spot off the Japanese coast where, as a little boy, he had often played. The low square stone house was set upon rocks well above a narrow beach that was outlined with bent pines. So, the house of Dr. Sadao Hoki is situated in natural surroundings at sea coastal area with a lot of pines nearby. Clear? And supporting himself on his bare feet, as he had seen men do in the South Seas when they climbed for coconuts. His father had taken him often to the islands of those seas, and never had he failed to say to the little brave boy at his side, "Those islands yonder." Yonder means there. Fine? They are the stepping stones to the future for Japan. So this is the beginning when Dr. Sadao, as a child, was raised by a typical Japanese father who was very orthodox, yes, New character has entered into the story, that is father of Dr. Sadao. He was very orthodox. He never believed in love marriage also. Fine, that's why he was never into the favor of this boy choosing a girl for himself in while studying in America. Fine, so his father was quite orthodox, typical Japanese person. But as a father, he gave his son a lot of preachings and values and morals. Fine, chote hote se hi, he kept on teaching him that you should be, you know, these islands, and he made him very knowledgeable personality, you can say. Where shall we step from them? Sadao had asked seriously. So his father used to say to him as a child that these are the stepping stones to the future for Japan. And at that time, Dr. Sadao, only Sadao, when he was a child, he was not able to understand to uske father kya bol rahe hain. Fine. Who knows, his father had answered, who can limit our future? It depends on what we make out of it. So his father was always there to encourage his son about his future. Now, Sadao had taken this into his mind as he did everything his father said. So Dr. Sadao was a true follower of values taught by his father. Hota kya beta? We, you know, keep on denying to what our parents and teachers say at this teenage. We are so full of energy. You know, that's why people keep on laughing and sometimes they keep on going into depression, and, you know, emotions are at peak in this age. And when anybody says anything to us, hame kya lagta hai ki ye to bas bhashan de rahe. They're just, my parents are always saying no to me, yahan nahi jana hai, ye nahi karna hai, wo nahi karna hai. Every time, why are you using the phone a lot? To whom you are talking? So you don't like the interruption. But, you know, they have experience. They have also gone through same stage. So unko pata hai ki kya hai. Fine. So with their experience, they want to teach you so that you do not follow the wrong path. Clear? So they want you to give the best version of the life. And when they say something to us, we should listen to them. There is always a reason behind what do they say to us. So when Dr. Sadao was very, you can say, follower of his father, he remembered the advice given by his father. His father never joked or played with him, but who spent infinite pains upon him, who was his only son. Can you imagine? Rather than, aajkal hum kya karte, apne bachcho ko comfortable life diya, AC should be there, one click away, information, tabs are there, gaadiyan hai aapke paas, everything you are having, even when we are not happy. Father of Dr. Sadao, he deliberately inflicted pains to his son. He gave him very tough life. Let me give you one example from the Bollywood. You know, Aamir Khan, everybody knows, fine? From his first wife, he's having two children. So he, one of his interviews, what he told his son and daughter, he has never given a personal car to them when they were going to college. Nobody knew that who they were. They were using the local bus and trains to reach their universities and college when they were just, they started their college and all. Fine. I'm not saying that one should avoid luxurious life. If you have, God has gifted you, use it. But one should know the feeling of pain also, and your life, you know, tougher the life is, the more tough you become. Jisne kabhi mushkil hi nahi dekhi ho, fir that person will not survive when the tough circumstances come. So that's why Dr. Sadao's father deliberately gave a tough life to his child by inflicting many pains to him. Kisko pata lage mushkil hoti kya hai. Sadao knew that his education was his father's chief concern. For this reason, he had been sent at 22 to America. Underline, those who are sitting at home, kindly underline this line. At the age of 22, he was sent to America. Likh lo ye point. Fine, to learn all that he could be learned of surgery and medicine. He had come back at the age of 30. Note down, after 8 long years, Dr. Sadao came back from America to Japan. Because he was, and when he came, he was fulfilling the dreams of his father. He was not only famous as a surgeon. I'm waiting for you people to concentrate, I guess, Anshulvij. You want your name to be highlighted everywhere in the recording. That's why you're doing this. sit properly then. He did not become famous only as a surgeon, but he became a renowned scientist also, the one who keeps on doing experiments. Because he was perfecting a discovery which would render wounds entirely clean. Why he was a scientist? Usne ek discovery karni thi. He was doing that. He was inventing that medicine, that after applying that medicine, wounds, even scar will go away. Nobody will even realize ki yahan pe koi wound tha, zakham tha. So he was into discovery of that. That's why he was a scientist. Fine. He had not been sent abroad with the troops. Also, he knew there was some slight danger that the old general might need an operation for a condition for which he was now being treated medically. And for this possibility, Sadao was being kept in Japan. So two reasons say, I told you that why during World War II, Dr. Sadao was not sent with other troops in the army. One, he was a scientist. He was doing experiments already, quite busy. Secondly, he was supposed to attend the major, you can say this general of the army whose health was deteriorating and he was in need of an operation also. So emergency ke liye usko rakha hua. Next paragraph. Clouds were rising from the ocean now. The unexpected warmth of the past few days had at night drawn heavy fog from the cold waves. Sadao watched mists hide outlines of a little island near the shore and then come creeping up the beach below the house, breathing around the pines. In a few minutes, fog would be wrapped about the house too. Then he would go into the room where Hana, his wife, would be waiting for him with the two children. This is the brief introduction of his personal life. After coming back, after long hours of work, he would come back. He would relish some time in the greenery and then he would spend some time with his wife and two children. Fine. And then, but at this moment, the door opened and she looked out. A dark blue woolen haori over kimono. She came to him affectionately and put her arm through his as he stood, smiled and said nothing. He had met Hana in America, but he had waited to fall in love with her until he was sure she was Japanese. Now, beta, we are going to get a peep into his personal life, that how he met Hana and all. So when he went to America for his higher studies, you know, he started liking Hana when firstly he met her only. But even, you know, he was such a blind follower of ethics taught by his father. उसको लगा कि firstly I should confirm whether this girl is a Japanese only na. If she happens to be some other from other nation, my father will definitely say no to it, to my relation. So that's why firstly he confirmed. When he was confirmed that yes, this girl is a Japanese, then he moved further with his proposal. Fine. So he had met Hana in America and he wanted to fall in love with her until he was sure she was Japanese. His father would never have received her unless she had been pure in her race. He wondered often whom he would have married if he had not met Hana. And by what luck he had found her in the most casual way, by chance, literally, at an American professor's house. So, kahan pe mila tha Hana ko? When they were doing their studies at one of the American professor's house. The professor and his wife had been kind people, anxious to do something for few foreign students. And the students, though bored, had accepted this kindness. Sadao had often told Hana how nearly he had not gone to Professor Harley's house that night. The rooms were so small, the food so bad, the professor's wife so voluble. But he had gone and there he had found Hana, a new student, and had felt he would love her if it were at all possible. So story is that Dr. Sadao, he would have never met Hana. Why? Because he never wanted to go to that American professor's house. Fine. That American professor, they have mentioned his name. let me find that. Fine, so you can read it later on also. I'm not able to find the name of the professor. So you can use the word American professor. Yes, Professor Harley. Fine, this is the name, you can note down, Professor Harley. His wife was very voluble, means very, some people, you know, they keep on talking for no reason. Very annoying. The atmosphere, the food, the rooms were very shabby. But they would give shelter to foreigner students. Students coming from different foreign countries. So he thought of not going to his house firstly. Usko laga mujhe nahi is professor ke ghar pe jana. But by chance he decided and he happened to meet Hana and fell in love with this girl. Okay. With this beta, I'm going to end the meet. So we'll continue tomorrow. Kindly bring vistas.